Hello, Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the RE100 Jagd Doga from Char's Counterattack. This is one of the more bulky RE kits. Nicely detailed, all the thrusters are colored, aside from the ones in the legs. I don't know why they don't have any inner red. I do like the black on the bottom here, it's nice. And the detailing on the shoulder armor. Would you call them shields? I don't know. The head looks good. You do have the photo stickers for the bird eyes and the mono eye. You also got some marking stickers. You can replace those bird eye ones with those if you want. I didn't. And it looks pretty good, all things considered. I don't know why it still has seam lines here. I think I easily got rid of that. And just like with the back of the legs, did a pretty good job there, but I don't know, shoulders are always a weird thing with the Zia mobile suits. I also find that the ankles are a little loose going forward and back, the way they go together. I don't know, I find that the polycap in there starts to separate, and it just loosens it up. So eventually he'll be like going forward like that. It doesn't fall over, but it's still a little weird. Also, the mounting units for the funnels are a little weird, because I know where they're supposed to go in. There are these little indents in the funnels, which kind of hook into the gray part, but they're not always... You have to find the exact sweet spot to get them in there, or they just kind of move around and sometimes fall out. Although, I don't know how they could have done it any better to look as good, so... You gotta... take what you can get, really. But, I mean, for the most part, it is a very good... That's a little wiggly in the torso there. But, I mean, if it was a master grade, it'd be more solid. But, I guess it wasn't popular enough. I'm just glad we got a variant of it, because it is a pretty cool-looking kit. And so the head's ball-jointed. And there's a little lever underneath. To move the eye, it's very stiff on mine, I can barely get it to move. The arm can go forward and rotate. The shoulder armor here is ball jointed, so you can get it out of the way. Get the arm to go out that far. Rotate on the shoulder, one joint at the elbow, about as far as it would go anyways, even though it's single jointed because of the thruster there. You got a ball jointed wrist. You got the hinge in the chest. So from the waist, front skirts can move together, I mean you could separate them if you want. Hinge side skirts, which are a little weird, the way they go in, because they're actually hinged in 2 points. And then the back skirts can move. And the legs are on a track, they can go forward and backward independently. And then they can go... about that far forward. It's a little, it's forcing it a little bit. I can get it. Whoopsie doobie. Yeah, just the skirt's gonna stop it. We can go back and out. Rotate the thigh. You've got two joints at the knee, which are not too bad. And then you have that ankle joint, which can go forward and back. Side to side, and some rotation. So, it's nothing spectacular, but it is a bulkier mobile suit, so I wasn't expecting anything amazing. But you can get some poses with it. It's not gonna blow your mind, but, and you have to contend with the ankles. But it can do some, you can do some decent posing. So, of course, we have the funnels, which can just unpeg. There's little teeny baby clips on these parts. And they basically go into these little indents in the funnel. And these work a lot like the other ones, like the newer ones we've seen from, like, the Sosby. Where, I mean, I guess you could push in the thruster there, but I like to let open the fins a little bit and then push it the rest of the way. Which pokes out the beam emitter. And it does look pretty cool. I like it, and it was very easy to put together, I felt. And the coolest thing is that they actually give you a way to display them. You get this little contraption, which will connect to the back. Goes into the backpack. These little grooves here, which don't look, I mean, they're not, it's not out of place. It just looks like detail. Goes in there. This will let you connect it, I guess, to an action base if you want. Alright, so let me get the camera up so you can see this. So then you can just connect a funnel to the rod and the hole in the thruster. And there you go. So you can have them all sticking out. Now the rods are usually a lot longer than what I have. Like this is a normal one. I just cut them all in half because I don't feel it needs to be super duper long. You can keep them long and have them all over the mobile suit coming from all the different directions. I just did that. I'm not going to display like that, but it's cool to have the option to do so. It's a pretty snug fit. So I think that's pretty cool. It's just a little teeny thing, but it does its job well. And then try to clip these back. Like I said, they have to make sure it's in the indents. And it's not super hard to knock them off. Yeah. And so we also have the shield, which is very nice. I love the fact that this symbol is just a part of the yellow. It just feeds right through. No sticker required. It is really cool. I love that. We got the peg here that's hinged. So you can peg it into the underside of the arm. Like so. And then the hinge allows you to just have it at the side without a problem. And of course, we have the beam rifle, which has two stickers. Not a big fan of the red one. The pink one's not too bad. This one looks kind of crappy. They have enough red here. They could have just given us a little piece of pig on there. So not a big fan of that. Also a little one there. It does look pretty cool, I think. Kind of unique. And you have a little thingy here. Does have a peg on either side of the gun. So if I get the hand apart. So it'll peg in and be very secure. Why we don't have a trigger finger hand, I don't know. I think that's a bad idea. You should always have one. Because, I mean, it really needs a trigger finger out there, but I don't know. They decided not to. Kind of annoys me, but what are you gonna do? I mean, I guess it's not super obvious if you're not really looking at it from the side. Can you really tell? It still bugs me. And then we have under. Oh. This shield, you're gonna have to be able to see it. Hold on. Get rather. In the skirt armor, this panel. Get. Whoopsie. I just want to take the panel off. Okay, we'll take the skirt off. That'll make it easier. Just take the panel off. And we have an extra weapon in here. A melee weapon. Which, since you have two side skirts, you'd think you'd have two of these, but you only have one. And actually, that's a very weird way to have it in there. You think there'd be like a hinge instead of just forcing it on and off. Whatever. But I do like this thing. It's kind of cool. So we got like a switch knife, switchblade comes out here. And then we got the you get two clear yellow beams, although you'll need the one. That pays like that. And this thing is different. So it doesn't have to have a beam, you can always just use the blade here. Or you just leave it like that. And you've also got the peg on either side of the handle. Which I'm kind of surprised considering it's a kind of a small weapon. They'd have it on both sides. But I do appreciate it. I like it when I can have my mobile suit a lefty or a righty. Oh yeah, this part does slide forward like that, which allows you to get the hand. Sliding backwards is more for storage. Now it's a little wobbly, not too bad, because I mean, you could always push that back a little bit. And there we go. Not too big, but I mean, being in the side skirt, it should be. I think it's pretty cool. So all in all, the accessories are pretty good, I feel. Once again, I really think that should not be a sticker. And a trigger finger hand would have been nice. I do like the fact that all the rifle here, all the molding is, like, it's the panel lining instead of seam lines, which is weird because the shoulder armor didn't have... Oh well. They do different things. I feel like certain people design the weapons and certain people design the armor. And they don't quite talk to each other sometimes. But I still do like the accessories. They're pretty good. Well, I was going to compare this to the Master Grade Sazabi, but it's behind some other kits and it's really, really dusty. So I decided to do some other ones. So here is the Jagan. I think that's, that makes sense. And then how about the another RE, the Bawu. Let's get the camera a little higher here. And then finally the Jagd Doga with the Gyunei Doga. Well, pretty good. The Jagd Doga is definitely a big mobile suit. So yeah, that's the RE100 Jagd Doga. I like it. I don't think it's my favorite RE, mostly because it does seem a little wobbly in certain areas. I think it could have been constructed a little more solidly, especially in the ankles. The fact that you don't get a trigger finger hand, which is really weird. At least one. Come on. It's just strange. I can't really complain too much about the funnel placement because I don't really know how they could have done it without it being really bulky to hold them like super secure. So all in all, I think it's a pretty good kit. So that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.